Good morning. Microhydro system controller doing very important role in the quality of power. So there are so many high type of microhydro controllers. Now I am going to explain different type of controllers, and I have invented my own controller that has special features with respect to conventional available type of controllers. To explain that special features, I want to explain what presently available type of all controllers, and then I can explain what is the difference between my controllers and available conventional controllers. Now let's go to micro hydro controllers. Basically, controlling technology used in hydro power. Number one, water flow controlling. Number two, electric load controlling. Water flow controlling generally used in large hydro power. For micro hydro power and pico hydro, most economical and most popular type of controller is electric load controller. So here we only pay attention only electric load controller. What is controlling? Controlling, there are three main areas to identify whether it is controlling or not. They should have stable voltage, again stable frequency, and in AC power, that is the waveform called sine wave output. If these three the parameters are within the range, that is good control hydropower system. In our national grid, hydropower is voltage is 230 volts, frequency is 50 hertz, waveform is pure sine wave. If we can reach even in our micro hydropower same quality, that is a very good quality control system. Here sine wave is mathematically shown in this graph, but due to lack bad features of some controllers, this sine wave distort as shown in this graph. Then there's a lot of problem creation due to this distortion of the waveform. Here I have get some pictures from oscilloscope from available few type of hydropower controllers. This is the best type of waveform which is available from the national grid, but this is the waveform which is given from micro hydropower controllers. Here you can see lot of distortion falling in the waveform. Those are serious effect on the controller lifetime, and as an effect of this waveform, controllers, generators burn out thoroughly, and maintenance cost has been increased drastically. Here schematically shown what is the simple hydropower distribution system. Generator is there, and village line, and with parallel to village line there is a separate electrical load called ballast. For good control system, this generating power should be exactly equal to the village load plus ballast load. That can be shown as a mathematical equation: power generating equal village load plus ballast load. Village side, the villagers want to switch off their equipment as requirement day to day life. Then this is automatically fluctuate. Then what is done by the controller? The balance excess power from the generating power divert into the ballast. That is the controller controlling main purpose. Here we can show you mathematically. Let's consider 10 kilowatt hydropower project. If village load is 10 kilowatt, ballast load excess power is 0 kilowatt, so it is not required to ballast. Whenever villagers switch off 2 kilowatt or some many power, village demand reduce up to 8 kilowatt, and ballast have to switch on exactly 2 kilowatt. Again, if villagers further reduce the
power, any 5 kilowatt, 4.7, 1.23, whatever kilowatt, the balanced output should be exactly equal to the total valiant load plus bad loss equal to 10 kilowatt. Those values are in this screen. Now, to control the micro hydro project, it is very clear that there should have variable ballast load, variable electrical load to compensate this excess power. Here, these are some type of ballast used in the hydropower project: electric heater, different type of air cooling, water cooling heaters have to be installed in the hydropower project. This is from this flow chart. It is showing how to control the controller working. Whenever I start the power hydropower project, it is sends the village load. If village load is reduced low value, then increase the ballast load. Again go to starting point and sense again what is the village load. If it is the village load increment, then reduce the ballast load. This endless loop continuously running generally 100 times per second. This loop sends the voltage. If there is an increase or decrease of the village load, select this two path and adjust the ballast load. This is whatever type of hydropower controller, this is common for any controller. This loop. There are four type of hydropower controllers at present. Basically, there are so many commercial names used for hydropower controllers, but technically these are the main type of hydropower controllers available in present all the countries. Electronically, here main difference is the variable load or ballast switching technology. That is the most important, most critical point in the control system, because when ballast load switching very fast, very high speed, it is generate noises, distortion of the sine wave, and seriously affect on the quality of the power. The first type of controller called binary weighted load controller. The second type, phase angle controller. Third type, mark space or pulse width modulation controller. Those three types of controllers used in hydropower. The fourth type controller is the design I myself with combination of these two type of controllers. Now let's go to identify what are the difference between these type of controllers and what are the advantages and disadvantages. Binary weighted load control. Of course, this controller used in early part of the 1990s. At that time, electronic technology was not so much developed, very rough controlling system. As a very rough controlling system, this binary weighted load controller used in that system. Simply, there are few number of separate electric load light. 1 kilowatt, 2 kilowatt, 4 kilowatt, 8 kilowatt. Here you can see when they move from left to right, capacity of the heater double. That is called binary weighted load. From this combination, we can select 0 to 15 kilowatt any value with 1 kilowatt accuracy. For example, if we want to select 13 kilowatt, it can be select 8 kilowatt, 4 kilowatt, plus 1 kilowatt, total value 7 kilowatt. If you want 7 kilowatt, 4 plus 2 plus 3. Similarly, this binary load can be switched. Here there are electronic operator switches are there. Controller automatically switch on this requires ballast load and adjust the ballast load as required for the match to the excess power on the hydropower project. Here the same things graphically showing here. different ballast kilowatt capacity is shown. The relevant combination here we shown. If we want to select 7 kilowatt, we can go to here 1 kilowatt plus 2 kilowatt, 4 kilowatt. If we want to go to 3 kilowatt, here we can 2 kilowatt plus 1 kilowatt. This is the advantage of binary loads controller. Here, as I mentioned, this is used in 1990s, but it is there are some drawback of this controller. From this combination, it can be selected ballast load only 1 kilowatt accuracy. We can't select 12.5 kilowatt or 9 kilowatt, 85 whatever decimal point. So when it was connected to this such a controller hydropower system, voltage suddenly vary with a small percentage. However, it is not suitable for modern electronic equipment like TV, radio, CFL bulb, which has electronic circuit. Another disadvantage is, this is again sine wave is there. This x axis is the time axis. We don't know what is the time of switching on the binary loads. In case of this binary load switch on this sine wave middle position like this star point, or here it is create sudden load on the system and waveform distort. Here it is showing graphically, again as two load switch on, sine waveform distort again. This is a very bad effect on the this hydropower controllers. The next type of controller called Mark space controller. This is come with new technology called thyristor technology. Here with support of brick rectifier, AC power convert into DC power, and technology called pulse width modulation used to adjust the ballast load. Here AC power converter, this is the form of waveform when AC power converted into DC. Here you can see some space is there between each columns. That is switch ballast off time. On time shown in the hatch area. The pulse width PWM technology has special features to this column width can be adjusted very smoothly. When all the columns have same thick, width, when it is width increased to up to this touch to the next column, 100% go to the village. When it is reduced the width of these columns, that is called reduce the pulse width modulation, then reduce the ballast load. By this technology, it can be adjusted the ballast load as required to control the hydropower project. One of the disadvantages of this very high frequency waveform chopping. In that case, it is generate radio frequencies. Unfortunately, this technology is not used. This technology trained the local hydropower technologies before 2000, but that due to some trouble in the disk controller, our hydropower developer didn't use this controller more than 3 years. Unfortunately, I haven't seen any control in Sri Lanka or India this technology. Again, due to that pulse width modulation, this is a form of wave go to the village. You can see sine wave superposition with very high frequency waves, that is due to pulse width modulation. This distortion also seriously affect on the hydropower controllers. This technology, according to our developers, this technology electronic component burnt out in the lightning period, and general maximum lifetime is less than 3 months. So many trouble has faced, then they didn't use this technology. Then let's go to third technology called phase angle controller. This is very important because this is the most popular hydropower controlling technology at present in Sri Lanka and other countries. Here this use technology electronic component called triac, which can be chop the sine wave as shown in the graphically in this screen. Here half waves of AC power is shown. The bottom line show the triggering triggering signal. According to the triggering point can be changed from 0 to 180 degrees. According to the triggering point, this hatch area can be increased or decreased. This hatch area is equal to the ballast capacity. When the triggering point move to here, ballast operate their maximum load to 100%. When it is moved to the right hand, ballast capacity reduced. By this technology, electric load can be smoothly adjustable zero to 100%. For example, if there is a 10 kilowatt ballast, we can switch on ballast any percentage very accurately. Here again, so the same picture in different special steps. If ballast have to be run with 100%, the trigger and pulse have to be given beginning of the each half wave of the AC pulse. If we want to run this 50% ballast capacity, this triggering point have to move 90 degrees position. Again, if we want to reduce further ballast load, we can adjust this triggering point as required. This hatch area proportional to the ballast percentage. This is the most common hydropower controllers used at present. Very high reliable with respect to binary load type controller. Again, there are a few disadvantages of this controller. When triggering at the 90 degrees or peak position of the sine wave, it is create a huge distortion in the waveform. When you observe in this type of hydropower controller, you can identify red lines with a voltage flickering, reduce the brightness, blinking brightness, that is exactly at 90 degrees switching position. Sometime suddenly this go out of the controlling and controller burn out suddenly due to this flickering, increasing of this flickering. Again noise generate, and there's again all the ballast is pure resistive load, that is act as a inductive load, that is also not good for hydropower projects. That is another disadvantage of this controller. Again, as you saw in the previous picture, each half cycle part of the waveform cut and that is generate cyclic load pattern, that is lead to generate electromechanical stresses on the generator, turbine, bearing, area, that is also not reason to generate reduce the lifetime of those components. Again, when ballast switching at the very peak area of the waveform, suddenly increase the current flow through the electronic component or switching device in this control system, and that is called very high DI over DT. That is not good for the triac component and reduce the lifetime of the switching device. Here, as I mentioned, at present there are a lot of versions of these controllers, phase angle controllers. Here I got the oscilloscope pictures from few controllers available in Sri Lanka. three type of controllers. Here you can see ballast waveform and village waveform separately. Of course, ballast waveform distortion is not so important because ballast is a pure resistive load, there are no any harmful. But problem is village waveform, you can see in behalf of sine wave, distorted sine wave go to the village. The second controller, you can see in addition wave frequency, it is create very high frequency in the system. Those are very bad for the electronic component in the controller itself and the relay load, such as CFL bulb, TV radio. The lifetime drastically reduced. Now let's go to effect of noises. I explained all the three types of controller generate noises at different reasons. Those are very badly affect on the hydropower controller itself and other appliances in the system. So most of the controls suddenly fail within 1 year, month, 2 months, few months due to these noises. Again, it is badly affect on the CFL bulb, which has electronic circuit, again TV, radio. Their lifetime drastically reduced this noise generation in the control system. Again, generator efficient reduce the efficiency and reduce the lifetime of the capacitor bank, which is come with the induction generator. Again, most of the measuring instrument show wrong values when you go to measure the voltage or current in the system. Noises affect badly affect on the measuring instrument and may display wrong values. At present, there are so many versions of phase angle controller in the market. This is Hummingbird controller that is available free of charge in the internet. Again, I could find another three type of controllers available in the web. Whatever the brand name or name, finally the ballast load adjusting with the technology called phase angle controller, controlling technology. So all these controllers generate lot of harmonics and badly affect on the micro hydro system. Here you can see capacitor burnout, suddenly generator burnout. If you closely monitor hydropower project, maintenance cost drastically increased due to this sine wave distortion. Here, this is taken from one of the hydropower project in Sri Lanka called Inubakanda Village Hydropower Project. Everything in the my single language, but you can see values. The maintenance cost is very high. In next slide, shall you go to it is mentioned in brief. From on that project, maintenance cost for the period of 13 months is 160,000 rupees. That is very high cost. That is that cost is equal to actual cost of the controller. They have spent annually a very high cost to maintain the hydropower project. In addition to that, there are a lot of indirect cost, burned out the bulbs. Again, they have to stay in the dark, and lot of they have to stay without electricity and have to be used kerosene oil. Again, they have to spend lot of time to repairing work, meet their technicians, identify troubles, everything. So actual annual actual maintenance cost for this period 13 month is almost 200,000 by considering this direct and indirect cost. This is another case with a village hydropower project called Amara Gedara. This is a controller we installed. After two years, controller completely burned out. Unfortunately, I could not capture the picture because it is converted into black due to my smoke. Smoke can shoot. Now let's go to my controller, that is called zero crossing binary weighted load controller. By forgetting few first two words, binary weighted load controller is the controller which I explained as the first type of controller. Here I add another new technology called zero crossing technology. In addition, this controller uses a digital electronic technology, so it can be at any number of ballast load. Here you can see binary weighted load controller load combination pattern, but this my controller, it can be at some more different loads and it can be achieve very smooth controlling. Let's go to the here this is the binary weighted load controller. It has, for example, in this case there are only four electric loads, 1 kilowatt 2 kilowatt 4 kilowatt 8 kilowatt. Total ballast capacity is 15 kilowatt, but for this my controller I have had another small load, 0.5 kilowatt and 0.25 kilowatt for same ballast, then it can be controlled very smoothly. Further, all the this electric load switch on switch off at the zero crossing point of the sine wave, so it is not generate any distortion in the waveform. So this controller has very high reliable with respect to other type of controller. Again, here I use microcontroller, programmable microcontroller. So lot of modification can be done with software without any modification of the hardware component. Here in this diagram it is shown the zero crossing point of the whole waveform. In my controller, this ballast switch triggering pulse view exactly at the zero crossing point of the each half wave of the AC power. Here, as mentioned earlier, I have at so many small load in addition to 8 kilowatt, 4, 2, and 1 kilowatt. Minimum load, very small load, 125 watts. Load is there, so minimum largest step in the control system is 62 watts. So very small step is there, very small step is there. Very smooth control controlling can be achieved with this controller. Again, I could capture the waveform of the ballast and the village from this zero crossing controller. Both have very smooth sine wave. There is no any distortion in the waveform. As mentioned, this all the ballast switch on and off at the zero crossing point of the waveform. High reliable. Again, it can be at any number of load, not only 8 kilowatt, another 16, 13, any number of load can be adjusted for, depend upon the capacity of the hydropower project. Physically, whatever type of controller, physically control panel is same thing. Electronically, you can see somewhat complex control circuit is there for my controller, because there are different large number of electric loads are there, so electronic circuit is somewhat complex, but physically it is same as other controllers. Another few advantages of this zero crossing programmable controller is can explain as below. It can be identified any uncertainty of the system, voltage, temperature, frequency in the system. In such a case, it can be automatically switch on or switch off. Protection alarm signal can be given to the can be give output. Again, if we want to further detailed study of the hydropower system, it can be captured data electric performance into memory chip or data logger with this digital control system. Again, this zero crossing binary weighted load controller can be modified ELC or IGC for single phase or three phase controller without any modification in the hardware side, just software, all the modification can be achieved. Again, as your mobile phone, day by day lot of features come into your mobile phone. Similarly, micro hydro controller, this digital controller can be at lot of features, displays, alarm system, even other protection, over voltage, under voltage. Again, if you want to monitor the system with GSM network, lot of features can be added because all the control process done with digital electronics. Another one of the disadvantages present the available controllers is shown in this graph. Let's consider our controller initially fixed output voltage as 230 voltage. That is remain exactly whenever village load is switched off. When village load gradually increase, the system voltage reduced at the powerhouse another 10 to 20 kilo or 30 watts volts due to bad disadvantage of the other controllers. Here you can see if the village load is zero, output voltage is 230. As increase 0 to 100 load, village load, system voltage reduce. Few voltage, that is maybe 10 to 30 volts. Then let's consider 20 voltage drop at the powerhouse. Then there is another voltage drop in the distribution line. Ultimately, power end houses receive less than 180 volts due to this voltage drop in the controller. But my digital electronic controller, I have identified what is the load percentage of the village, again automatically adjust the voltage to same voltage, then throughout the voltage village demand variation it can be maintained same voltage at the powerhouse, finally minimize the voltage drop in the system. Thank you. That is a brief description on my hydropower controller.